What has happened?
Your brother.
What's he done this time?
The newspapers are all over Tupini's murder, and if that weren't enough, someone has stolen the currency printing plates. Was that also Jacob's doing?
I doubt it.
Now, no one trusts the bank or England's currency. There will be inflation, riots, manufacturing will jump to America for the cheap labor. In short, Britain is done for.
Jacob, you've really put your foot in it now. What if I smuggle the plates back into the bank?
Well, it'd certainly help. Better yet, it would call into question the stories on Tupini's murder, which would restore confidence in the economy.
That's settled then. Britain lives to see another day.
Oh, and if it's not too much trouble, would you mind destroying any counterfeit notes you come across so they don't circulate?
Of course.
It really is very good of you to help.
No more exploitation! No more slave wages!
Follow me. The counterfeit money is being spent nearby. Well, if you can call it counterfeit. With those printing plates, it's nearly impossible to tell the real notes from the fake ones.
Mr. Abbott.
If this gets out... Well, I've said this already. When people don't trust their currency, and we're already seeing riots...
Mr. Abelai.
You two, follow me. I don't wish to be robbed on my way to the cart.
Who is she hiding
from? The counterfeiters.
Heard about the rioting at the bank?
Looks like she's planning to surprise
them. They can riot all they like. We won't be giving back those plates.
That's unforgivable.
Difference does it make? It's not like he has any real cash on him.
Since we've got the printing plates, it's all real cash.
Did you hear those crowds? Sounds like all of London is rioting.
Nothing to do with us.
I'll just pretend. I can't believe Jacob's managed to shatter the entire economy. Father was right. He acts in haste and repents not at all.
Hold up your ass.
Keep your eyes open. Anyone could be trying to get in.
Yes, sir.
Keep this place locked down.
Yes, sir. Ah!
Guard this place as you would the Bank of England itself.
Absolutely, sir.
Oh!
now to sneak these back into the bank.
Strange lady, mad as a march is.
Do not make me keep looking for you.
You should have listened when you had the chance.
There, as if they were never taken.
Ladies and gentlemen, try to remind God. Well, the London papers are running the story of how it was all a hoax. No more riots. Faith in the bank restored. Finally, I might get a quiet night on patrol. Miss Fry, I can't thank you enough.
Glad we've averted catastrophe, Sergeant. Although it's Jacob who should be thanking me.
What's this nonsense about needing a password to see Lord Cardigan today?
Relax. I've got it in my pocket.
Look sharp, men. Allow no one past unless I authorize them.
Cardigan has gone too far this time. I've a mind to contact Scotland Yard myself.
Come now, gentlemen. I thought us united in opposition against this perfidious law.
Truth is that, however possible it may be for committees of this House to be impartial on the question to whom the seat shall be awarded, and I do not deny often impartial in that respect, nor is it hopeless that they might be always so. Nobody inside this House, and I think I may almost add in it, believe that so long as the jurisdiction remains in this House, the penalties against the giver of the bribe will ever be serious.
Thank you. Can't imagine he's up to any good.
Pardon me, gentlemen. Sergeant Freddy Abberline of Scotland Yard. Where might this scandalous activity be taking place?
Oh, yes, yes. It's, just this way. Follow me, Sergeant, but discreetly, if you would. One doesn't like to be seen airing a fellow member of Parliament's dirty linen.
What? I'll be very discreet.
Usually I would be in disguise, but my clothes all fell into the Thames.
I'm gonna grind up your
bones! Oh, finished! I can't escape!
now.
I'm a member of Parliament, you cretin.
No password, no passage.
I've waited an eternity to get my hands on you.
I'm worried about you. I feel there may be spiders living behind your eyes.
A little pigeon has no fashion sense.
I'd like to have a look for myself. Just...
Begging your pardon, my lord. It's time for a meeting with Lieutenant Pierce.
Eh?
We have finished!
How dare you! Someone's here!
Found you!
You took a wrong turn somewhere, boy!
Get out of the way, vagrant! You too, peasant! Where do you get your energy from? No silly Sally! Dispatch the bastard!
The hero of Balaclava should fall not on the gloried fields of Crimea, but to an assassin's blade in the very halls of power.
Are you finished yet?
Take your bow, knave, for you have managed what no Russian battery, what no Indian tiger could achieve. Claim your trophy, and may you choke on it.
Yes, but do tell me more about Balaclava.
Farewell. Farewell, dear Britannia! Your dawn shall be dimmer that the Earl of Cardigan sees it not. God save the Queen and the 11th Hussars!
What a prick.
Apart from the death squad on our tail, apart from that.
Backup's on the way. Why are you pushing yourself so hard? It's not your job to fight Templars.
I had this colleague. He was our boss's son. I didn't much care for him at the start. Everyone treated him like he was so bloody special. To me, he just wasn't invested in anything that didn't affect him personally. But I was wrong about him. He became my friend. Put himself through hell, and he saved us all in the end. So I reckon, well, I can't apologize to him, but I can, I don't know, I can try and live up to his example.
You are a good assassin.
Holy jeez!
Hello. It has been too long.
Galena, Blimey, I have not seen you since we blew up that lab in Paris.
Duh. There were many explosions and you screamed like a baby.
Bishop tells me Otzoberg is here. I will kill him for you.
Super. Great news. Now, if you wouldn't mind keeping watch, I am going to lie down and die now.
Rest. We have a big fight coming.
Sean and Rebecca are...